The only thing I didn't like is, like, I don't give a fuck if he doesn't like an old guy rapping. I don't really care. I'm Slim Shady, it's not the real Shady, or the other Slim Shady, it's just imitate. We're the real Slim Shady. Please stand up. Please stand up. Yes, I'm Slim Shady. Yes, I'm the real Shady. I'm the real Slim Shady. Just imitating with the real Slim Shady. Please stand up. Give it up for Kenute, Campbell!
First of all, my name is not Kenute, so whatever you say, that's some racist shit.
Bro,
I'm gonna talk about my real name. I know my hand might be like chicken scratch. I'm sorry, I got big hands. I can't write. I haven't wrote since the sixth grade. I can't write. I type on computers. I'm 20 years old. I'm the youngest person here. How old is everybody here?
21.
21. Oh,
41.
41.
Oh, excuse me. I am sorry. Mm-hmm. Well, my name is, you know, it's hard to pronounce, so bear with me. I'm gonna break it down to two ways. My name is Kenute, or in Jamaica, because I'm Jamaican, it's pronounced Kenute, right? But me growing up, people, even if I explain it to you how I just explained it, they'll butcher my name. They'll call me Kahoot, Kenute, Kanuck, Kahoot, and it was gonna be mad. I remember one time I was in my class with my teacher, you know, and she was like, Kenute, come to the board and start writing down the questions. You know, I'm on the board, you know. I forgot what it was, multiplication. I fucked up. And then she was like, Kahoot, can you please sit down? I was like, how the fuck you mess up my name? I've been in class for how many, like 4 months, and you messed up my name already? Come on now. So you did it on purpose to get me mad, you know? Okay, cool. And you know how hard it is to have a name, because my name is Kenute Hugh Campbell. I have two of the whitest names, but the blackest name in the beginning that you cannot pronounce. So when, you know, this is a funny joke I used to say to my friends all the time. When I fill out job applications, I don't put Kenute Campbell, I put Kenny. Because it's easier to pronounce Kenny, and then when I get there and they look at me like, what's your real name? I'm like, my name is Kenute. Like, why'd you put Kenny? I was like, do you really think I'll be here at this interview if my name is Kenny? It sounds like somebody that's going around robbing people. Fine. Me, no. But you know, I understand. You know, I understand everything. I'm gonna talk about a little relationship things, even though I'm kinda young, you know. I was always taught from a young age, and listen, I say this with, you know, the nicest and kindest of my heart, stay away from Latino people. Because, you know, they're kind of crazy. But, you know, I never listened. So, you know, when I was young, I was talking to some girl, I'm not going to put her name out, I'm going to call her Katrina. So, you know, I was talking to her for a little while, and long story short, you know, I found out she cheated on me. And the way I found out she cheated on me is because she thought I was stupid, right? So let me break it down to you. I was in Baltimore and she lived in New York. I was in Baltimore for the summer. And then my dad called me. He was like, hey, I seen your girlfriend and she's with some guy. I was like, where are they? He's like, at a bus stop. I was like, you sure, sir? He's like, yeah, I passed by her 4 times. I was like, God damn, 4 times? You seen her 4 times? So I'm like, oh, okay, what'd she say, shy to you? He's like, yeah, but she looked kind of, you know, kind of scared. So you should probably ask her about it. And my cousin, you know, he's not like me. He's not open up. He was trying to be, you know, fit into the black stereotype, a little thug. So, you know, he was like, man, fuck her. When you call her, I'm cursing her out. I'm like, nah, just wait. I want to see what she's going to say, you know? She calls me, she's on the phone. And I'm like, hey, how you doing? She's like, fine. I was like, good. You know, how was your day? She was like, you know, it was fine. I stayed home all day. I was like, oh, that's number one lie. I was like, nothing happened today. She was like, no. Nothing significant. She was like, no. I was like, you didn't see anybody? No. I was like, are you sure? No. She's like, oh, I'm gonna call you back. I was like, oh, okay. I hear the phone. 30 minutes passed by. Actually, the same thing. Before she got the last note, my cousin was like, you lying bitch. We know for a fact that he saw his father. He's like, who told you? His father! And my mother was in the car too! So why you being tell a lie? So you know, long story short, I was numb, I still continued talking to her. But then I drew my last straw. I drew a straw because then she tried to talk to one of my friends. You know, my friend, you know, I love my friends to death, those are my friends in the back. Not one of them, because you know, they're ugly as shit. So he told me, so I was like, okay, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna be very professional about it. I left some of my stuff at her house. I'm gonna go over to my house, go over to her house and get my stuff and leave it at that. So, you know, also I just remembered that I'm black, I'm 6'1", and I don't look like the very safest person. So I brought my white friend Daniel. My friend Daniel, he's very clearly put everything fine. I'm like, yeah, I believe them. So I was like, yeah, you know, I'm holding up, I'm getting my stuff. She's like, let's talk to her. I was like, no. I got to her door, rang the door, but nothing in the door. She opened the door, pushed me out the way, closed the door behind it, locked it. So I was like, oh, why is she locking the door? I'm going to get my shit from inside the house. So I was like, I just want to get my stuff. She's like, no, we need to talk about this. I was like, there's nothing to talk about. What am I talking about? What are we talking about? I don't want to talk. She was like, no, let's talk. I was like, is your mom inside? Because I knew her mom. You know, I'm very respectful when I come to meet parents and everything like that. So, you know, I was like, I'll just tell your mom I won't be around anymore. Thank you for, you know, hospitality and everything like that. But I'm not going to be around anymore. She's like, no, you're not going to do that. I was like, I'm going to ring the doorbell. Before I could reach my hand and touch the doorknob, I heard electricity coming from her pocket. And I was like, oh, fuck, no. She's about to tase me. So I backed up, and she launched and missed me. My wife, for a day, was like, get your ass back in the car. Come back. You're not doing this today. She's going to call the police. You're going to jail. Come here. Right? So I got back in the car. I'm in the car. I'm mad. You know, most, I don't talk to her anymore. But as long as I'm talking on the topic of the police and everything like that, as far as I'm concerned, I love police. Except for this. I don't know what the project is, right? But I love police, you know? As long as they don't do nothing wrong to me. Funny story, my friends in the back know this story.
Fucking trash.
We got pulled over. We got pulled over 2 weeks ago. And we got pulled over because the cop said he could not see my friend's license plate. Which, he was wrong for saying that. Then he said there was tents in the window. But I have no problem with you pulling us over. Because there's nothing wrong we're doing with the car. It matters on how you pull us over. Oh, I see the light. Shit, I gotta get it going. So, picture. I'm in the passenger seat, the driver's on the left side, somebody's in the back, another person's on the, behind me, right? Okay, the guy, the officer comes up and knocks on the passenger side in the back, knocks mine on the window. He's like, sir, I need your identification. He was like, why? You're pulling with the driver, why are you trying to talk to me? He was like, I need to try to see who I'm working with in the car.
What's that?
So, you know, he started talking to everybody and everything like that. Me, I don't have anything registered in New York because, you know, I do everything in Florida. Shout out to Stan, Florida. So, he's questioning everybody, being very rude, you know. And then he comes to the car, he was like, sir, what's your name? I was like, I took my name, I took my own name, date of birth, I took my date of birth. He was like, are you sure? I was like, yeah, I'm positive. He was like, okay, I'll be right back. Right, come to the door, he was like, what's your name again? I was like, I told my name. He was like, and then it comes up, but it shows a female. I was like, what female? I have a sister. He was like, how many sisters do you have? I was like, three. So I named all my sisters, youngest to oldest. And then he's still, you know, he's still lying to me. He's like, oh, I believe that you're not 20, you're 21. So I'm like, what's the difference? I told you my date of birth, but I am 20. So what's going on? He was like, kid, cut the bullshit. Can you tell me what your name is? I'm like, what the fuck? What? Who's going to come up with the name Kenute Hugh Campbell? Who? On the top of their head. He's going to be like, my name is Kenute. But anyways, I'm going to stop right there. My name is Kenute Campbell. Thank you, everybody, for enjoying my
Nice fight. He did that.
Give it up.